Hi guys, Arindam here.
Hey!
And in the final video for my extinction map, I will be giving you a tour of my entire extinction base on single player. So let us begin. My base is located here. Let me show you at 49.8 by 58 on the sanctuary location. Why did I choose the sanctuary location? Simply because in this location you will not get any corrupted dinos, you will be shielded from the meteor strikes, and most important of all, you are center to the entire map, so you can visit all the titans, you can visit all the drops and complete all the waste events, and everything will be relatively close to you. So another thing to note is, where exactly did I place it? Generally I place all of my bases, you know, at the level ground, which is close to a water source and all that thing. But in this case, in only a special case for extinction, I chose to have my base somewhere above. But by above, I mean far, far above. So my entire base is located on this and bridge-like section on the front part of the sanctuary. The reasons for choosing this location are as follows. One, I wanted to make a big base with my museums, and I needed a big open area. This is one. Second, the entire area is flat, so it is very easy to construct foundations, and you won't require pillars and ceilings and all those things. Third, and very importantly, in the sanctuary, it is always sunlight. There is no concept of night and all those things. That combined with the fact that I don't need any electricity because of the sunlight, so that I can easily make my base in an open area and I don't need to have any ceilings above my base to protect myself. Now, the place where I built my base, there are no threats to my base at all. I mean, there are no dinos apart from Tapeharas and Archaeopteryx that spawn here. And quite frankly, my base is perfectly safe from everything. There is no danger at all in this area. Hence, I have chosen this place. And, well, let me show you something. So, how do I get water? First of all, I get water from this below pond. And for that, I have chosen here. This is my pipe. This pipe goes down below and goes to that water area. So now that you have seen my water infrastructure, I will give you a tour of my base. Well, it's going to take some time for me to get up. Now, I have chosen a pattern for my base building. So, on aberration, I've mostly gone with metal and stone. But extinction, because it is mostly based on tech, everywhere you can see tech structures. So, the entirety of my base is covered with tech structure. There is no stone, no metal, nothing. It's only tech and tech. And that goes with the theme of extinction itself. Now, since there is no threat, I can build on an open area like this. This is the, I think, a 22 by 22 square where I have all of my buildings and resources, and my museums are like this, which you might have seen in my earlier videos. So I'll tell you what dinos I've used. So this mech, if you have seen my video for the Gamma King Titan, I have used this mech with lots of rockets to kill the Gamma King Titan. This one, if you have seen my Forest Titan taming video, I have used this mech with, you know, the Ascendant Siege Cannon module to tame the Forest Titan. I built though at beta level. This is my personal Giga and my most powerful Giga, which is has a bunch of mutations. All of them are on melee, by the way. And this is my, most of my dinos here have been taken from other maps. So I have taken whatever important dinos I could find from Islands, Scorched Earth and Aberration using transfers. So these are all from my island map, and with the same names also. This Quetzal, if you remember, this is the Quetzal I have used to kill the Desert Titan. I have put my Giga inside that and let it go into aggressive mode, which have allowed me to build the Gamaking Titan very easily. This Tropiognathus was a tame that I have taken from Crystal Isles, and when Crystal Isles released, this is one of the first thing I did. I just tamed one of them and put them, made sure it come here. Reason for taming this guy was first to check out, and second also to get its dermis for the museum. Same goes for Ragnarok with my Deinonychus. This Tekrex is the one I've used for clearing the Tek caves on the island map. These are also from this. They are all from the island map. If you have seen my island base video, you will note on these are the same creatures. This is one of my gachas. Now I wanted to make a Kibel farm, and instead of making a Kibel farm with the usual dinos, I wanted to make a Kibel farm that has some unique hard to reach dinos. So this is my Kibel farm. You have the dodos, which is obviously dodo will be for basic Kibel. Now instead of raptors and other dinos, I have tamed Compsognathus. Taming them is easy, but keeping them down after you have knocked them with a with fists, it's pretty hard because the torpor drops very fast. And these Caprosuchuses are for my I think these are for regular Kibbles. Again, problem with Caprosuchuses are that as of us, there was a patch in which after the patch you cannot actually use your flyers or your Argent Avis to hold the Caprosuchus in their paws. Now taming these two were tough, especially taming the Megalania was very very tough. Now this is just for fun, because taming a Megalania and using it for Kibel is a cost prohibitive operation, because these guys I think need extraordinary or exceptional Kibels, and they need a lot, and I mean a lot of narcotics to put them down, because these guys drop torpor very fast. And just for curiosity and just for fun, I tamed these guys, because other than that, Megalanias are pretty much useless to me. Then these two are my boss battle making Therizinos from the island map. Similarly, these two Eutyranas, well, they are actually the mutated versions of Eutyranas I've taken from the island. And I've used children from these Eutyranas for my boss fights. This Tek teleporter is meant for show. I never found any use for teleporters really, because I can do the entire teleportation much cheaply and easily using a Tek transmitter. Same goes for the cloning chamber. I mean, problem with the cloning chamber is that even if after you clone a dino, you will lose its imprinting bonus. So the only dinos I would rather tame, or I would rather clone, will be a Reaper King, which without its imprint is pretty much useless. Well, I can obviously clone these guys, but again, without the imprint they are useless. This Eutyranus, the male, and there was a female version also. These two siblings together with the mate boost was used to complete the legendary element vein. And also I think I had used the female version to kill the forest and the ice titan. This is my enforcer used for completing some of the easy and medium OSDs. This is my primary, or this is my flagship dino for the aberration map. My first rock grade and the equivalent of my Argent Abyss one. And I needed to use this because it has very good transportation and very good weight capacity. So when I am completing red and purple OSDs, when I am completing the yellow and red element veins or medium and hard veins, I need dinos with a lot of carrying capacity, and my Argent Abyss alone cannot do it. So I use this guy as my secondary dino. My Mantis is used for collecting elements from the element veins. My Owl is mostly used for transportation as well as healing. These are my Villanosaurs. I wanted to actually make very
much mutated Viranosaurs with the alpha male and three base female strategy. This is one of my most important dino actually. I've used the Wyvern a lot in this map for transportation and for gathering the different explorer nodes. Well, let me show you something. Now, my explorer nodes are absolutely complete. So let me let you see this. I have 100% completion rate for every single explorer node, and I have not used cheats for getting them. So you can see I have all the nodes collected. Up to extinction, that is. Every single dossier is collected. Now, for the guardians, there is a bug in this game. Guardians as well as HLNA. There is a bug in this game in whereby I have HLNAs 13, 14 and 15, and I have gotten the dossiers for the Mecha King Titan as well as Normal King Titan, but for some reason they just don't show up. Well, just a bug. Other than that, I have collected every single node, HLNA, glitch, everything on this game up till extinction. Only your Genesis remain. So that is like a 100% completion achievement. I use my, okay, now coming back to the dinos, I use my Phoenix for transportation, for cooking my meat, etc. And it feeds on Serpent. My Doedge is mainly used not for gathering stone, but for gathering element dust from the different chairs and benches we find there. Show you the location. It is somewhere there, this that part. Now, in my other maps I have used storage boxes, but in this particular map, since I am going with the tech theme, I have gone with a very simple case of the tech dedicated storage. So you will find that I have dedicated storage for practically every resource in the game, and they are all done in a systematic order, so that it's easier for me to understand which resource is at which location or which row and which column. And again, going with the tech theme, instead of using a normal generator, I have used a tech generator, which by the way is awesome, literally awesome. I had only filled up with say 100 something, and it has only expended like 7 or 10 element in all these days, and I am at day 108. So this is really awesome. It covers a very large area. I'll show you the range. Can I? Yes, I'll show you the range. And it covers all of my electronic stuff very easily. These are my sleeping pod as well as my tech trow. Again, not use a normal feeding trow, because tech trow combines both a trow as well as a fridge. Next, I have my other resources. So I have this for coloring as well as blue pins, and some of the ammo contains all the blue pins I've gotten from the OSDs. As you can see, I have used some of these blue pins on my aberration map to complete the beta, gamma as well as the alpha Rockwell, and I might have explained that things to you on that case also. This is my personal inventory, the ones I regularly use, with my best equipment stored in this place. This is for all the trophies. These are for taxidermy and some spare ammo. I had actually made a lot of ammo just for killing the different normal titans, but eventually they were not in use. This is for saddle and building materials. Most of these building materials have had no use. I have not had to construct most of them actually. They were ones I had taken from red and purple OSDs. This is for my weapons, armor and ammo. And these preserving beans were used, right now they are empty, but they were used for doing the jerkies. I have several cryo freezers actually. This is my personal cryofreeze, the one I store the most important dinos. This cryofreeze I use for storing the dinos that were used in the breeding process, in temporary intermediate stage breeding dinos. On the other hand, there are lots of these cryofreezes. You check them. These are all the dinos I have used for these are all the dinos I have used for getting the taxidermy museum set up. So I had to tame a lot of them, and I had used them for storing them. The reason I have these dinos tamed is because, one, not all of the dinos can be found on this map, so I tamed them on other maps, brought them over into this map, and only after bringing them over to extinction, I actually took their dermis. Because there is a bug in which the dermis, if you transfer between different maps, dermis will become will get cleared, and there will be invisible dermis inside. So I had to tame all of them up and bring them to this map. So there are a lot of dinos. Now let's come to the fridges. This is for all the special things like kibbles, food and dishes. This is for prime meat, jerky and lamb chops, normal meat, fish meat. They are actually color coded. So normal meat you find on animals that roam the land, so it is color coded with green. Fish meat you find on fishes which are in water, hence blue. Jerky is mostly dark in color, so dark red or brick. Prime meat is more colorful, hence red, and these are orange. Similarly, we have advanced veggies, berries, black and white berries, as well as seeds. These are just eggs, I'm not storing eggs anymore. Okay, this is my greenery. Let me disable this thing first. This is my greenhouse. I wanted to make it decorative, so it has this greenhouse has every single plant that is present in this game up till extinction, which doesn't include primitive plus, by the way. So you have citronal, narco, stem, mayo, long grass. And then we have these two things, plant species X, Y, Z. Okay, this I had used this Quetzal for killing the desert titan. So I have used this Quetzal. As you can see, I'm inside this box. I have used this Quetzal for taming the desert titan on alpha level. Another of my gachas. This is my mating pair for the Madagamars. This is my mating pair for my Gigas. One of them has the skeletal skin, and the other one has the bionic skin. This is my personal mana, which I use for traveling mostly, and these are some of the things I use for building the museum. So as you can see, I have not spawned stuff in. I don't like to cheat and spawn stuff in, so this museum entirely has been done completely legitimately. No cheats and no boosted stuff. This is my personal megalosaur from Aberration, which only sleeps in this map and stores my skins. It has no other purpose really. This is my gas bag, my owl, and my this gacha is used for getting my organic polymers. It's my ankylo things and replicator, which I have used for getting all the ascendant giga saddles. This is my most important creature in Ark Survival Report. This is that one creature that I have used from the island. Same creature I have used on Scorchstar, same I have used on Extinction. Sadly, I couldn't use it on Aberration, hence I have that rock. This This gacha I have used for getting black pearls, which I have a lot, by the way, thanks to this. I have not had to use either the fabricator or the stuff. They are mostly used for storing stuff, because everything I've done is in the tech replicator. So that's about it. Well, I kind of look like a ghost actually from Scooby-Doo. So that's about it from my primary base. I've already shown you my museum, but I'll still show you a very rough part of it. I had used an online PNT editor to convert JPEG images to this PNT format, and these images I had to draw, and I had used GIMP for making these images. This is my dinosaur museum. I already have a video series explaining the paleontological significance in detail for each of these museums, so you guys can take a look at those things. If you have any interest about dinosaurs and other prehistoric life, and you want to know what your favorite dinosaurs actually were in real life, you can take a look at those videos, because they are rather, they're pretty much detailed. Me being a paleontology nerd since, over 25 years ago, I have made sure that I have crammed in as much information I can for this any of these dinos. So this is my dinosaur museum, on with my personal color, blue. Next we have the museum for mammals and synapsids. Again, this is just a basic tour. The more detailed tour I've already given on a different video. Now my video is slightly lagging sometimes. This is thanks to my video recorder Fraps, which decreases the frame rate and causes lags. Unfortunately, that's what I have to suffer, because Fraps actually gives your videos in lossless format, which is what I generally use, lossless instead of lossy, which other video formats do, like Nvidia Shadowplay. These are my reptiles. Okay, it lags a lot. Next we have the birds. Actually, one of the reasons it is lagging is because the game is trying to load a lot of new structures with a lot of colors and a lot of drums, and the game needs time to load all of these things up in memory. So it kind of lags a bit. Next we have the fishes. I had a lot of joy actually making this museum. So one of the highlights for me in this Ark Survival Evolved game is actually building this museum. Every time I think about the extinction map, I don't think about the titans, I actually think about taxidermy and the museum. This is the most important thing for me. I wanted to make a museum like this every single time. So I actually have a museum like this, smaller version of this museum, on my last playthrough. That video is also there. But that does not have all of the creatures which I have presented here. I've learned a lot from making that video, and I've used that knowledge to make this one, which is far better. One thing I will let you see is, you see that base over there? Let me point out that base. That's a very good place. That's a good place to set up a trap if you want to set up a trap. So I used to use my wyvern to pick up Villanosaurus and other dinos, and I used to put them onto that trap. Then I used to drag them from high above that ledge. It was easy and simple. So I have scoured extinction for a good base location for a couple of days before I actually settled on this base. So on my previous playthrough, I'd actually made a base on ground zero, but it was dark. It was close to the resources, but it was dark and it felt cramped. I wanted to make my, after the, you know, after playing Aberration, the dark gloominess of Aberration, I wanted to make a base that is bright and sunny, and you know, a base that is so far above the ground, it will actually have better frame rates when I make the videos. Hence, that is also another reason I chose this place. Lack of dinos, lack of structures and all these things, so that my frame rates are actually high up. It is only because I have made so many structures and you know, so much dinos, taxidermies, hence it is slowing up. There are many other creatures like raptor claws, gacha claws, bunny dodo, whose taxidermies I have not taken, simply because in many of these cases these taxidermies become invisible after restart, and sometimes these assets are removed after a subsequent update to the game. Same with the bosses, I have not put the Megapithecus, Dragon, Rockwell, Manticore and Good Mother here, because after taking their dermis and putting them after a restart, they will again disappear. Now, I'll finally show you my artifact museum. Again, I have a video for this. A video detailing every single artifact and trophy and flag in this game. As you can see in that video, these trophies were actually present. But now these trophies are completely empty. This was the Crystal Wyvern trophies. These were the trophies for the Broodmother, Megapithecus, Dragon, Manticore. But they're not there. They're not there. Why are they not there? Because those trophies, you know that you cannot actually transfer trophies between servers. So for making this museum, I had to actually spawn the trophies in to make this museum. And after the restart, those trophies vanished. Yeah, some of them vanished, some of them did not vanish. Strangely, the Master Genesis trophies like the Master Controller and the Motor, they did not vanish. Same with these three guys. But then you would be like, how are these four still there? The reason is, they are not actually the trophies for, they are not, these four are actually not the trophies that you get while you actually defeat the boss. These are the generic trophies. The generic Megapithecus. This is, see, multiple values. It's not called Gamma Megapithecus. I think this would also be called, this is a Gamma Broodmother trophy, but this has a different Unreal Engine 4 ID compared to the actual Gamma Broodmother trophy that you get while you defeat the boss. Same with the dragon. This is the generic dragon trophy. Same, the generic Manticore trophy. See, it's called Manticore trophy, not Gamma Manticore trophy. Hence, these things have not disappeared after a restart. Thankfully, the plaques also do not restart. So, yeah. That's my entire extinction base. I had a lot of fun making this base, and extinction map took a long time for me to complete. I think it took a lot of days, over 1.5 months just for the extinction, compared to like 1 month for each of the other three maps, like Islands, Forest of the Navigation. So most of the time I took for making, most of the time spent on extinction were actually for, you know, farming enough tech material and building the museum. So that's my last video for extinction. I will be moving to Genesis after this video. So till then, stay tuned and thank you for watching. It's been a pleasure doing all the things I did in extinction, and I would love to see more from you guys and hear what you think is going well for me. Till then, thank you and stay tuned.